how peonage kept blacks enslaved in America. Slavery was incredibly profitable. It supported America's economy in its infancy, and after its abolishment by the 13th Amendment to the U.S. Constitution, the effects of all the laws and systems that were adopted in place of slavery continued to deny black descendants of American chattel slavery the citizenship rights granted to them by the 14th Amendment. The southern states adopted black codes, or grandfather clauses, and access to civil, political, and social rights was not much better in the north, where segregation remained the norm. After Congress ratified the 14th Amendment to grant civil rights to black Americans, the Supreme Court narrowly interpreted the 14th Amendment to guarantee only federal enforcement of the privileges and immunities of citizenship. However, states were left free to determine the citizenship status of their residents individually. The Supreme Court further restricted the power of the 14th Amendment in the 1883 civil rights cases by ruling that the 14th Amendment barred only discrimination in state action, but that private racial discrimination was an unprotected social matter. In effect, the U.S. government was sanctioning divisions between civil, political, and social rights when the citizens affected were black Americans. With the U.S. government refusing to meaningfully enforce the constitutional grant of civil rights to black Americans, it was hard to be genuinely free from enslavement. So many black American agricultural workers returned to virtual slavery in a system known as peonage. Now, peonage, also called debt slavery, is a system where an employer compels a worker to pay off a debt with work. Legally, Congress outlawed peonage in 1867 with the 13th Amendment, along with slavery. But without the U.S. government enforcing the constitutional amendments, black farm workers returned to work at the plantations that had previously enslaved them and agreed to work for money that was often printed by the plantation owners themselves and usable only at the plantation owner's store. These black farm workers became indebted through unfair sharecropping arrangements. They often lived in shacks on the plantation. Plantation owners would deduct rent for these shacks from owed wages at rates that also kept the black workers indebted. Sham accounting practices were common, and some plantation owners even entered into contracts with black farm workers with no intent to ever pay them. There were also local and state governments that contributed to keeping abusive peonage alive by picking up black men for minor crimes or on trumped-up charges. The men would then be assessed excessive fines and court fees, and then forced to work for a local employer who would pay their fines for them. Southern states also leased their convicts en masse to local industrialists, but then conveniently lost records of the debt, trapping some convicts in leases that never ended. The peonage system endured well into the 1940s thanks to state statutes that protected it, and many black Americans found themselves in a continuous work without pay cycle. They were still building wealth in America for others, not themselves. Video courtesy of the freemaninitiative.org. Donate to freemaninitiative.org today.